Well, let me just say first that our relationship with the United States remains robust and very active. Yes, we're hoping at my level, that we're hoping the ASEAN ministers are hoping still to have a meeting with Secretary Tillerson. I think it's only a matter of scheduling problems. But certainly we are in touch with the United States. As you know, the president already talked with President Trump earlier this year. And we are also in touch with the U.S. at various levels. And also at senior official level. So I think the opportunity for us here is really how to increase the number of discussions we have with U.S. officials. I think, you know, the State Department is still in the process of reorganizing. And I think we also have to give them some time. So, but in the meantime, we are as much as possible trying to maintain contacts. With a view to enhancing our cooperation with the United States at the bilateral level, and also try and also with the United States at the regional level, in the ASEAN context.
Yes, Marianne.
Good morning, sir. I'm Marianne, and I work for Radio France International. Do you have any updates about the situation?
Louder, will you click on your microphone, Marianne?
Okay, is it working?
Oh, louder.
Okay. Do you have any updates about the situation in the Spratlys? And also, updates about the Chinese investment or any place financed by the Chinese and soon to be inaugurated? To be open.
Well, I think our economic managers would be in a better position to ask that. But yes, China has already indicated their willingness to invest in the Philippines, especially on infrastructure.